really well. Is that contraction there now?
Yeah.
My name's Dana, and this is Emily. We're going to be looking after you until your baby arrives. Well done. Nice, slow, deep breaths. That's really good.
Hello.
Hello. Is the doctor to come and say hello?
Samantha, is it? Welcome, other doctors here. Nice to meet you. You're doing well?
Yeah.
All right. So I'm just outside reading about your very complex history.
Yeah. It took us 3 years to become pregnant with our first. It's a little girl, Victoria, which we were just so excited.
So what we're going to do now, it looks like you're contracting really well.
Yeah.
So hopefully when we break your waters, things will progress nice and quickly, and we'll be able to deliver baby quickly as well. All right.
Okay. Unfortunately, at 25 weeks, I went into premature labour. I was rushed to Birmingham Hospital because they had all the specialists and care that I would need for premature baby as well. We had hope and we were told that the survival rate is good, but the delivery wasn't smooth. And I was rushed into theatre.
That's when I didn't know or see anything anymore. Just waiting outside with Sammy's mum, my mum, not knowing what's going on.
They managed to get her out, and she's had stopped breathing. So they spent, I think, was about 15 minutes resuscitating.
So what?
Painful.
The neonatal baby doctors came out and told us, it's time to hold your daughter, because she's going to pass. And once, but she waited for us.
I held her, and she passed away in my arms.
That one gone? All right, yeah. We'll be as quick as we can.
Relax your legs there for me if you
all
can.
Right. All right. Well done.
Because of Sammy's leukemia as a child, she always has a higher risk in pregnancy. Because of her platelets, they're always a little bit lower, so therefore she is more of a risk to hemorrhage.
Now, when you move, after this contraction's gone down, I'm going to get you to go towards me, over the back of the bed, OK?
Oh, my gosh, I don't know.
You don't know about this?
It's so painful.
It helps bring baby in the right place, I know.
Oh.
That's it. Nice. Deep breaths and relax into the bed. That's her. Down a lot faster than before. OK. That's it. Well done. Relax. It's okay. It's okay. Stay nice and calm. It's fine. Go with it. All right. Relax those legs.
Tony obviously finds it a little bit difficult. He sees me in pain and can't control anything that's happening. And I think that has come from his background of being in the military.
Well done, that's it. That's it. You can see baby's head. Baby's coming.
He's not good with that lack of control or that he can't help.
Baby's head's just crowning. Here we go. And we've got baby's head. Ooh. Well done. That's fine. Okay. Baby's coming. Congratulations. Baby's here.
Oh, my God. Oh,
Quickly.
Oh my God.
Don't panic, please.
Oh gosh.
Don't worry about the bleeding, okay? I'll be all right. I just want the baby. Is the baby okay?
Yes, he's lovely.
Hey. Mum, it's okay.
Right, I want you to turn over in just a second, okay?
Yeah.
Severe blood loss is terrifying, to be honest, because it can be so rapid and so dramatic and so sudden that you've got to really act very, very quickly.
I'm going to pass baby through now.
Oh, I know, it's a lot.
Pick him up. Yeah. Turn around, darling, as quick as you can. Well done, right. I need to get to the centre. Oh, sorry, everybody. All right. Can you pull the emergency buzzer, please?
Oh, my God. Ever since Sammy's illness as a child, the fear of losing her always stayed with me up to this day.
I think we are going to have to take you to theatre, I'm afraid, OK?
What's going to happen,
Mother? What we just need to do is take you into theatre to examine you. We pop you off to sleep, probably, and then we're going to need to put a big catheter that goes inside the womb and blow it up with some water, and that usually compresses it and stops the bleeding. If that works, great, wake you up, come back here. If the worst comes to the worst and we can't stop the bleeding, we'll have to operate, we'll have to cut your tummy open. And we'll have to take the womb out. We'll try very hard not to do that, but that's where this could end. I think it's very unlikely. Okay. Normally the balloon works really, really well. Okay.
Are we ready?
It was hard leaving Tony and my new baby. But at the same time, I put a lot of my trust and faith into the medical teams, and I was happy that the baby was here safe and with Tony. I lost nearly 3 litres of blood, so it was quite a lot. When I was in theatre, they put a balloon to add pressure to stop the bleed. And luckily, that was successful, so I didn't need to have the hysterectomy.